has the envelope. In the envelope are the names of the top five finalists for So Nick, all very tight, all collected? Yeah? Excellent.
All in order.
Thank you very much indeed, Nick. Okay. So, here we are.
Not looking.
You can have a look. Yeah, this was you last year, this was it. Okay. So, the top five, in no particular order, the ladies are as follows. Deanne Kempfenshaw. So if we could please have just the best of order, total silence, to give the finalists, as you can imagine. They look cool on the surface, but their heart right now, if you monitor them, probably go through the roof here. So to give them their best chance of answering the questions properly, if you could do it in, total silence. Anybody who doesn't, we'll probably invite you to enjoy the rest of the night from in the foyer, if that makes sense. So, question number one, that will go to Deanne Kentish Rogers. Okay, right. Deanne, congratulations on being in the final.
Thank you.
Now, your question. If you could relive one moment of your life again, which moment would that be and why? I know you've only got 30 seconds, but go on.
Thank you. Life is meant for the living, and if I could live one moment, it would be my Commonwealth Games debut. It was a moment that empowered me, made me feel powerful. I was with people who are like-minded, who are challenging themselves, and it raised my spirit and made me feel amazing. And I think that's how all women should feel. And that is what I want for all women. Okay. Thank you.
those whatsoever. Fantastic. Thank you, Deanne. Second question, we will be asking to Simran Vernon. Simran, congratulations. You're going to be walking second. Here's your question. Tell us one thing that you weren't taught in school that you'd like to see added to the curriculum for the children of today.
Good evening, Cardiff. Percy, I would like to see children being taught how to keep a positive mindset throughout difficult situations, as many students end up in difficult situations such as bullying or injuries or things that bring them down, and it's very important that they're educated to know how to bring themselves back up to regain their confidence and conquer the world the way they should have been.
Hi, Vicky. Well, congratulations. Your question, this is a good one. If you could be Prime Minister for a day, what would be one thing about Great Britain that you would change and why? Remember, you've only got 30 seconds.
Hello, good evening, Cardiff. If there was one thing that I would change as Prime Minister, I would make it compulsory for mental health awareness to be taught in schools. Using my own journey, I've been through mental health difficulties, and I think it's really important that the children of today know how to combat these stresses, these anxieties in life, and come out as better people afterwards. Thank you.
Our finalists, please welcome Maria Narva. Hi Maria, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now, here's your question. What do you believe has been the UK or Great Britain's greatest gift to the world?
Oh, that's a great question. Good evening, everybody. Good evening, judges. I think Britain's greatest gift to the world, I think, is women's confidence. Women supporting each other. Everybody, even social media, you know, it's been put down, but it actually helps. And I think, I mean, the girls tonight, we all support one another. And I believe that, you know, the UK, it's amazing. We all support each other. Look at tonight.
Oh, 30 seconds is nearly up. And last but by no means least is the lady who will be fifth of all for the judges tonight, Parker Frew. Here's an interesting question for you. Parker, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Miss America put an end to the bikini round in pageants this year. What are your thoughts on their decision?
Thank you for that question. I absolutely respect the organisation's decision. I think that they have an organisation that they run extremely well and they have a reason behind it. But I think it's incredibly important to be fit physically as well as emotionally and mentally. And I hope that Miss Universe Great Britain continues to champion body image positivity, health and fitness, and keeps the swimsuit section. Thank you.
Hear from the contestants in pageants, but I thought they did fantastically. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Give them 30 seconds, quick as a flash, and that was the lead, they'll come up with an answer. Ladies, I'll ask you to take your places at the back of the stage now, please, if you could, because we will get the finalists to walk for our judges one final time. By the way, I did give Anna the chance to ask a question, and she politely declined. That all right if you wanted to ask a question to me. But no, we'll share the load, it's okay. So, walking one final time, one of these ladies will be Miss Universe Great Britain 2018. And first up, would you please welcome back, Deanne Kentish-Rogers.
Our top five.